Fatima was another woman that I met in Bosnia, and she lives in Mostar. Tarek started the interview by introducing himself and his mother on camera, and then he gently kissed her on the forehead and said, "This is my mom, and I love my mom." She then told me about her youngest son Imitus, who was born on July 8, 1995, just a few months before the war ended and the Dayton Peace Accord was signed. And like all mothers, you know, she bragged about what a smart boy he was and what a good athlete he was and how proud she was of him. I asked Tarek to ask his mother what happened to her youngest son. Tarek's voice trembled and his eyes watered as he looked at his mother sitting next to him. I asked him again, "Please ask your mother to tell me what happened." She went over and picked up a picture of her son and held it against her chest and started sobbing. On October 28, 2005, 10 years after the war had ended, Imitus came home from school, did his homework, went outside to play soccer with his best friend in his yard, and his friend stepped on a landmine. His friend died instantly, and my son, my baby, was 2 or 3 meters away. He was still alive when my husband got to him, but he lost too much blood and died on the way to the hospital. He died in play. I asked Fatima if she had anger towards the people who left the landmine. "I only have love for a child. There is no space for anger." And then she said to me, "And if there's anyone in this world who can stop this, please help."